Howdy folks, welcome to my channel. This is your Chief Marine Mate Edu. Today, we have the continuation for the Part 5C loading cargo operation. We'll be doing the completion of loading, final allages, topping off, and cargo calculations. But before anything else, if you haven't subscribed yet, kindly click the subscribe button and click like if it pleases you. Let's begin.
As mentioned in the previous video segment, Part 5B, during early stages of loading are critical. It has been mentioned that a lot of factors affecting the loading operations, particularly where significant distances exist between storage tank and jetty. Hence, monitoring tank pressures is observed regularly. Take note that an uncontrolled venting is not acceptable unless otherwise an emergency occurs for some reasons. This is why loading rates are not constant in the early stages. It can be reduced or increased as loading operation stabilizes. Remember also that this is in effect are all connected back during inerting and gassing up operation, where efficiency of the purging operation must be at high success standards. It has to be noted that quantities of incondensables are always present, especially when our scenario was that the vessel came from dry dock and not in the usual pattern where trading was normal, for example, previous loading voyage with the same cargo. Throughout the loading operations, monitoring a close watch on a cargo tank pressure, temperatures, liquid levels, interbarrier spaces or void spaces, pressures, etc. has to be clearly and efficiently done by the duty officer and watchman or crew deck, and most especially the chief officer, who is in charge of the operation in general. Bear in mind that liquid levels may be affected while the reliquary function plant is in operation, which means while boiling of liquid takes place, bubbles of vapor may give a false reading, especially with float gauges system. This happens with the floating gauge type is fitted in your ship, then momentarily suppressing the reliquary function plant operation is applied. Sometimes when surveyors at the completion of loading, they request to stop the plant operation when doing the cargo measurements. Towards the end of the loading operation, loading rates must be reduced to an appropriate rate as previously agreed with your staff in order to accurately top off tanks. Take note that careful overfill will be activated because the terminal won't be able to react immediately. One of the main contexts of the pre-loading discussion is that a notification time shall be given prior to the completion of loading. For example, 2 hours before completion, an hour before completion, 30 minutes before completion, or some would ask for every 10 minutes or 5 minutes until the last minute of the topping off. So this is very important as we reach the final stages of loading operation. Now bear in mind that the final density or official density will be received the soonest possible time. In most cases, it is being given by the terminal at the last stages of the loading, sometimes even in the last few minutes of tapping off. So it's quite important that you have to verify and contact the terminal side, provide you with such official density the soonest possible time. This gives you time to recalculate your cargo quantities, because once the official density is given, this means to say everything has to be changed, especially your sounding or alleging finishing point. Now take note that in our previous discussion, our final nomination was 49,608.778 tons. But we stipulated the MOLO, which is minus 5% or plus 5%. Then with 5%, we came up with 52,689.218 tons. Or with less than 5%, we have 47,128.339 tons. So basically, this figure, we just assume that we maximize it to plus 5%. Now, if we receive the official density from the terminal, hence, of course, we have to change and modify our finishing allege or sounding, because this would surely will make a great impact in the quantity that we will be loading. So if we go back to the loadicator or loading computer, and let's see how we may find out what will be. Assuming that the density that we had before is about 0.5822, then with the final density, they gave us, like, say, for example, a smaller value. And let's just say round it up to 0.5800. So let's find out what will be our final sounding, and let's compare from the previous one. In theory and principle, because the density has been given, it's a little bit smaller, smaller, then we should be able to add more weights into our cargo. But as you can see, intentionally, I have also utilized a warmer temperature, which I mentioned also in the earlier discussion of this video segment, that with warmer temperature instead of the fully refrigerated as told by the charterer or the terminal, then it means that the volume that would occupy with this temperature is bigger. Hence, we cannot load, increase, or add more weight into the quantity that we have already nominated. So meaning to say, instead of that, despite of the lesser density, unfortunately, the warmer temperature that I have put in this simulation is warmer. Hence, the cargo quantity that would come up is a little bit less. So if you look at the allergies and sounding, you could see here that the sounding is a little bit different. We still be able to maximize it to 90%, but if we check now the gas report, which is I'm just gonna expand it in here, we should be able to take in 52,579.291 metric tons. But as you can see, if we check also the draft as of this moment, you can see here that the drops is just exactly a little bit 0.01 only, meaning to say we are within the summer load line. But take note again, our nominated cargo, based on present condition, is that we will exceed basically the quantity. See, that's 52,579 compared to 52,789.218 for the plus 5%. Oh, we cannot do that. So in dense, with this simulation, we should adjust the finishing allergies or sounding. Meaning to say, we have to lessen the volume that we have to take in. Say, for example, we put in here 0.97.8. So about 97.8 also. I'm just gonna make it pass. 97.8. Blah, blah, blah. Now let's check the gas report and see what it will become. So still we are still above the 5% of the nominated quantity. So we have to lessen, we put it down to 97%. And that's just the thing with the planning and changes of density. So the sounding that you have planned or the finishing will not be the same when the completion of loading is close. We go back here. So in reality, this would not give you a lot of issues because it would take only a couple of minutes. So as you can see, we have here about 52,042 compared to 52,089, meaning to say we are on the safe side, and nearby we can actually load to this kind of level. As you can see, we can utilize this one, for example, observe level at propane for tank number one, port and starboard is about 18.55, same almost at the starboard side. And of course, number two tanks 18.3, and almost the same with the starboard side. And number three, just a little bit difference, but they're all close. And well, this is the purpose of the leveling valve, wherein you need to stagger and make sure that they are almost the same. Now take note that when you are dealing with this recomputation and recalculation of the finishing allege, you have to consider also your list, your deballasting is completed, and at the same time your trim of course are in the right, I mean to say, with good seamanship. If not even keel, then you should be at least trimmed by the stern, not trim by the forward. That's not a good seamanship. So that's how you deal with this kind of cargo. And this is not only applicable to LPG ships. It's all basically all applicable when you are dealing with loading in any type of ships. A good seamanship, for example, is that when you load up to your maximum, either it's an even keel or a little bit trim by the stern, not trim by the forward. And so now that we have the stopping allerges or sounding values so that we could finalize our topping off, then all we need to do now is to make sure that we have staggered the tanks so that we could finalize which tank will be top off first and which tank will be top off last. And at the same time, having notified the terminals and the surveyors and have people and additional crews are manning the deck, like some are already standby on the bulbs, manifolds, and of course checking and confirming the reading of the sounding of the tanks as we get closer to its topping off. Once we are ready, then the people on the manifold area will be notified as well, and at the same time take note that make sure that the terminal are fully aware of the completion, so we give them ample time to prepare so that once we said stop, then the loading stop. Of course, loading rate at the same time has already been reduced to just an optimum wherein we can top off safely and accurately. Now, take note that in any case the terminal was not able to take action immediately, then if there is a shore link that has been connected, then we could also activate the ESD shore link. Else, we could start closing our manifold valves. But take note that this is also not a good practice because in the terminal side, it would surely give them a big problem. Like, abruptly closing the valves would change pressure, and at the same time, it would definitely create damages or some, if not even injuries. So you just have to be prepared with all these things, and that's why the notification in place at the moment where you're close to completion. So again, after the completion, then of course closing the bulbs will be done. Okay, now assuming that we are already on the last tank and just about to finish, so now we give the signal to the terminal side on the jetty and we tell them to stop loading. So immediately once we said that, we can now confirm if it's stopped, then we can start closing the manifold valves. At this point, I am closing now the manifold. Now take note that during the draining, we need to leave at least one of the tanks open. So meaning to say, some of the tanks may have been closed already during the topping off, but then again on the last tank, for example, let's say your last tank was number 4, you could always leave that open, or you can select a tank with the lowest level. So say if you have already informed the terminal to stop the loading, then you shut the manifold valves, or may perhaps sometimes they request that just leave the manifold valve opens and they already mentioned that they have stopped. You could also confirm that because you could see that there is no more pressure on the manifold lines and there is no flow while you are monitoring it through your online computers, or even in the manifold you could see if there's a flow or not. The crew could actually notice this. So hence it is safe that you can leave one manifold open, and at the same time you can also leave one tank open, but you just have to be careful and watchful and monitor these things. So in respect to this, find the tanks with the lowest level and leave it open. So assuming tank number 1, which was the first one we top off, and it turns out that it is the lowest level, and you can leave that one open and just close the other one, so that when the draining of the liquids, blowing of the lines will take place, then of course some of the liquids will go down to this tank, and of course the rest of the liquids that is in the line from the manifold to the side of the terminal will be pushed back or blown away using hot gases. In this case, I'll show you what comes next. After this, then of course at the same time, prior to that, surveyors are on board, representative from the terminal are on board, and then of course the cargo survey and cargo measurement commences, and from there calculations will start. At the same time, securing all the system will also be done by the rest of the crew, while the cargo engineer will just continue of course running the plans to stabilize the pressure and temperature until it fully stabilized and close to its atmospheric pressure. Now let's assume that cargo survey, measurement, and determination of cargo quantity loaded has been completed. Likewise, both parties represented by the terminal and the ship side has agreed that loading operation is fully complete. Of course, it is expected that note of protest and many other documentation follows. This will be discussed in another video segment. So now we can proceed with the demonstration of blowing off liquid through the lines. In this demonstration, we shall assume that the plant are still running and it has been temporarily suspended during the measurement. This depends on the cargo surveyor if they requested so. But assuming that the plant number one is still running and we are sending condensate turn to trunk number one, I'll take note that we will be blowing hot gas to the manifold line so that we could clear the liquids from the manifold side to the terminal. So hence, we can draw the vapor from the tanks and we just leave the vapor valves open for all the tanks, but we'll be using plant number three to produce a hot gas. In this case, we will open valve 129 and of course, the suction valve for the compressor, right? So in here, for the meantime, we close the valve going to for number one because we don't want to have the hot gas go in there because we will be utilizing that line as well. So as you can see, we are drawing vapor from the tanks and hence it goes to plant number three, and from plant number three, as you can see here, there it goes, and that's the suction side, and we open the discharge side of the compressor. So now we are actually creating a hot gas. We are compressing the vapor and it turns into hot gas, and then we send it to this line 2 and 3, right? So if we go to cargo pipelines, that's the one that has been opened, and if we trace the line, we send it to 2 and 3 system, again to the liquid line, so that it will not go to the other line where the vapor is coming from. So this goes to the manifold, and of course it cannot go back and goes to the liquid because I have already closed it, as I've shown you a while ago. So if we go to manifold, basically this is the number 2 and 3 lines. It passes through here and it goes through here, and then of course we can now open the manifold again and it crosses through the crossover line, and we can close this one so that it will not go back to system 1 and 4. So now we can also open the manifold for number 2, where the liquid, where we have loaded the cargo from these manifolds 1 and 2. So now we are sending hot gas to the manifold lines all the way back to the, and pushing the cargo or liquid remaining in the lines all through the way to the terminal side until it's clear. So once this is clear, then we can stop and of course close the system. So let's just go back again to plant number 3 and we just start the pump. Right, so now we are compressing, we are now sucking in and then sending it back to the vapor line and goes all the way out of here, that is a hot gas, and connects all the way through the bulb 124 to the liquid line for number 2 and 3 system going to the manifold. So if we go to the manifold side now, it passes again through this 2 and 3 system, and like I have shown earlier, it is now going the manifold lines. Now, in most cases, the terminal will ask the cargo engineer or the ship side to close and open the valve to build up pressure so that there will be a stronger pressure of gas pushing the liquid all throughout their lines until it's completed. Now, with regards to cargo measurement, cargo calculation, and cargo surveys, for the ship side, in most cases, majority of vessel will utilize the so-called loading computers. So basically, just inputting the values from the cargo surveys. While on the side of the cargo surveyor, he or she will be asking the capacity table, calibration table, ASTM table, shrinkage factors, so that he or she will be able to do the calculation. I will give a different or a separate lecture for this, so that for the benefit of the cargo surveyors, they will be able to see also, especially for the new ones who are doing cargo surveys for gas carriers. So this concludes now our discussion for loading operations part 5C. For the next episode, please keep posted and be notified.